Hello friends, welcome back in current news updates. Still you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon. Today I will tell you national and international current news updates. First question is, which country has launched world's first brass futures contracts? Question is this, which country has launched world's first brass futures contracts? Option A, China. B, India. C, United States of America. Or D, United Kingdom. Let us see the answer. Answer will be the option B is correct. Multi-commodity exchange of India on March 25 launched futures trading in brass for the first time globally, which will facilitate brass stockholders to hedge their price risk. The country's largest commodity exchange will commence futures trading in brass on March 26 and will offer three contracts ending in April, May and June for trading with a lot size of 1 ton. Next question is, who won the junior ISSF World Cup in 10 meters in air pistol in women category? Question is, who won the junior ISSF World Cup in 10 meters in air pistol in women category? Option A, Manu Bhakar. B, Anjali Bhagwat. C, Sonia Rai. Or D, Sushma Rana. Let us see the answer. Answer is option A, Manu Bhakar. Manu Bhakar has won the gold medal in 10 meter air pistol women junior event in Sydney. Manu Bhakar secured India's second individual gold at the ISSF Junior World Cup. Next question is, Union Ministry for Social Justice and Empowerment has launched the first Indian Sign Language Dictionary. How many words does the dictionary contain? Question is this, how many words does the dictionary contain? Option A, 1200. B, 10,000. C, 3,000. Or D, 5,000. Let us see the answer. Answer is 3,000. Option C is correct. Union Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment has launched the first Indian Sign Language Dictionary, which comprises of 3,000 words in New Delhi. ISL dictionary is to remove communications barriers between the deaf and hearing communities, as it is focused on providing more information in Indian Sign Language. Next question is, in which city 5th India Maize Summit 2018 was held? In which city 5th India Maize Summit 2018 was held? Option A, New Delhi. B, Mumbai. C, Pune. Or D, Chennai. Let us see the answer. Answer is New Delhi. Option A is correct. Maize production in India has seen a boom in recent years, which has been possible due to increase in area as well as productivity. This was stated by the Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Radha Mohan Singh, at the inaugural event of the 5th India Maize Summit 2018 at FICCI, New Delhi. Next question is, the Anglo-Waltha movement, recently mentioned in the news, most closely resembles the option A, African American Civil Rights Movement. B, Kisan Morcha in Maharashtra. C, Chipko Movement. Or D, LGBT Rights Movement. Let us see the answer. Answer is Chipko Movement. The original Chipko movement dates back to the 18th century, when a group of 363 people from 84 different villages, led by Amrita Devi, laid down their lives to protect a group of khejri trees that were to be cut down at the order of the Maharaja, a king of Jodhpur. After this event, the Maharaja decreed that the trees were to be left standing. The original movement was called Inglawaltha, the Gadhwali word for embrace, as the protectors protected the trees by surrounding them and linking hands, physically preventing the loggers from touching the plants. The movement was later named for Hindi word Chipko, which means to stick. Next question is, which state assembly has recently passed a bill to hike salaries of MLAs? Which state assembly has recently passed a bill to hike salaries of MLAs? Option A, Tamil Nadu. B, Karnataka. C, Kerala. Or D, Goa. Let us see the answer. Answer is Kerala. Option C is correct. The Kerala Assembly has passed a bill processing to nearly double the salaries and allowances of ministers, MLAs, the Speaker, Deputy Speaker, Leader of Opposition and Chief with effect from 1st April. Next question is, who is the new Prime Minister of Ethiopia? Question is this, who is the new Prime Minister of Ethiopia? Option A, Haile Mariam Desalegn. B, Abiy Ahmed. C, Mulatu Teshome. And D, Negesh Gidada. Let us see the answer. Answer is Abiy Ahmed. Ethiopia's ruling coalition has elected Abiy Ahmed on 26 March as new Prime Minister following the resignation of Haile Mariam Desalegn last month. Next question is, an AIM proposed by a central task force set up under Union Commerce Ministry will focus on. Question is repeated again. An AIM proposed by a central task force set up under Union Commerce Ministry will focus on. Question mark is this. Option A, Artificial Intelligence. B, Big Data. C, Digitalization. Or D, Blockchain. Let us see the answer. Answer is Artificial Intelligence. A central task force on artificial intelligence, AI, has suggested creating a national artificial intelligence mission, means NAIM, National Artificial Intelligence Mission, that will serve as a nodal agency for coordinating AI related activities in the country. Next question is, which country has bagged maximum number of medals in recently held ISSF Junior World Cup? Option A, India. B, China. C, Australia. Or D, Japan. Let us see the answer. Answer is China. Manu Bhakar and Anmol secured India's 7th gold medal in the ISSF Junior World Cup by winning the mixed 10 meter air pistol event with a qualification world record on March 26. India occupied the second place with 22 medals, including 9 gold, while China continued to lead the tally with 25 podium finishes, including 8 gold medals. Next question is, which state has recently proposed a bill similar to Maharashtra Control of Organized Crime Act, MACOCA, to curb the organized crime? Option A, Karnataka. B, Bihar. C, Uttar Pradesh. Or D, Rajasthan. Let us see the answer. Answer is Uttar Pradesh.
The Uttar Pradesh Assembly on March 28 passed a stringent bill to curb organized crime and deal strictly with those trying to foment terror. The proposed legislation on the lines of Maharashtra Control of Organized Crime Act, MACOCA, seeks to curb organized crime and deal strictly with those trying to foment terror or dislodge the government forcibly or through violent means. Next question is, gallantry award given for distinguished services to military personnel is given by option A, Prime Minister, B, President, C, Vice President, or D, Army Chief. Let us see the answer. Answer is President. President Ramnath Kovind presented gallantry awards and distinguished service decorations at the Defense Investiture Ceremony held at Rashtrapati Bhavan. Next question is, who is the new acting chairperson of National Green Tribunal? Question is, who is the new acting chairman or chairperson of National Green Tribunal? Option A, Justice Jawad Rahim, B, Justice Madan Mohan Panchi, C, Justice T.S. Thakur, or D, Justice Deepak Mishra. Let us see the answer. Answer is Justice Jawad Rahim. Three-judge bench of the Supreme Court comprising Chief Justice Deepak Mishra, Justice A.M. Khanwilkar and Justice D.Y. Chandrachud today appointed former Karnataka High Court Judge Justice Jawad Rahim as acting chairperson of National Grain Tribunal, NGT. Next question is, cool EMS service started between Japanese Post and Indian Post will deliver. Question is, cool EMS service started between Japanese Post and Indian Post will deliver. Option A, Japanese food, B, Indian food, C, Japanese cars, and D, Indian silk. Let us see the answer. Answer is Japanese food. The service named as Cool Box service will ferry food from Japan to India. Commercial agreement of Cool EMS service between the Japan Post and India Post, through which fresh food can be sent from Japan to India in cool boxes to facilitate for the Japanese expatriates in India. Next question is, recent visit of Chinese Commerce Minister sought to address the following issue. Option A, border dispute, B, Chinese dumping, C, trade imbalance, or D, Doklam issue. Let us see the answer. Answer is trade imbalance. India and China on March 27 agreed to draw up a medium and long term roadmap with action points and timelines to address the trade deficit between them. Next question is, which team has won the 8th Men's National Hockey Championship? Option A, Punjab, B, Railway Sports Promotion Board, C, Odisha, or D, none of the above. Let us see the answer. Answer is option A, Punjab. Punjab was crowned championships of the 8th Hockey India Senior Men National Championship 2018. After they beat Petroleum Sports Promotion Board in the final match at Padma Shri Mohammad Shahid Synthetic Hockey Stadium. Next question is, in which city the first non-stop scheduled flight from Australia to Britain landed after 17-hour 5-minute journey? Option A, London, B, Glasgow, C, Manchester, or D, Bristol. Let us see the answer. Answer is London. Option A is correct. First non-stop scheduled flight from Australia to Britain, London, landed in London after a 17-hour 5-minute journey across 14,875 km from Perth. The historic Qantas flight QF9, a Boeing 787-9 Dreamliner with more than 230 passengers and crew on board, touched down at 5:03 a.m. at Heathrow. Next question is, who has been nominated India's representative to the Executive Board of UNESCO? Who has been nominated India's representative to the Executive Board of UNESCO? Option A, J.S. Rajput, B. R.K. Nair, C. J.S. Shah, or D. N.K. Sinha. Let us see the answer. Answer is J.S. Rajput. Option A is correct. The Ministry of Human Resources Development has nominated former NCERT Director G.S. Rajput as India's representative to the Executive Board of UNESCO. Professor G.S. Rajput was awarded the Padma Shri in 2014. He has been also awarded the Maharishi Ved Vyas Award by the Madhya Pradesh government for his contributions in education sector. Next question is, in which country the world's biggest cruise liner Symphony of the Sea has begun its sail? Option A, France, B, Germany, C, Denmark, or D, Netherlands. Let us see the answer. Answer is France. Option A is correct. The world's biggest cruise liner Symphony of the Seas has left the Shipyard of Saint Nigeria in France to embark on its maiden voyage in the Mediterranean. Next question is, name the person whose name was introduced in Mann Ki Baat by Narendra Modi for national recognition for his exceptional service to the society, as he has set up 9 schools being a rickshaw puller. Option A, Ahmad Ali. Option B, Muhammad Azhar. C, Akhil Kumar. Or D, Syam Kumar. Let us see the answer. Answer is Ahmad Ali. In Assam, Ahmad Ali's inspiring life story is already a folk tale in the Barak Valley. His story got more prominence after Prime Minister Narendra Modi mentioned in it in his Mann Ki Baat program of All India Radio on 25 March 2018. He is an illiterate rickshaw puller from Madhurban village of Karimganj district. Is really a personality for national recognition for his exceptional service to the society, as he has set up 9 schools. Next question is, which new communication satellite ISRO is gearing up to launch on March 29? Option A, INSAT-4CR, B, HAMSAT, C, GSAT-5P, D, GSAT-6A. Let us see the answer. Answer is GSAT-6A. ISRO is gearing up to launch the GSAT-6A, a high-power S-band communication satellite, on March 29. The satellite, with a lifespan of around 10 years, will be put into orbit by Indian rocket geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle GSLV F08. Next question is, which country's under 16 football team has lifted Jockey Cup? Option A, Nepal, B, Hong Kong, C, India, or D, Bhutan. Let us see the answer. Answer is India. India under 16 team has won the Jockey Cup International Youth Invitational Football Tournament title. In the final in Hong Kong, they defeated the
hosts by 4-2.
Recently, NASA announced that it will launch a new satellite to discover the new planets. What is the name of new satellite? Option A, Kepler, B, TESS, C, Explorer, or D, Range. Let us see the answer. Answer is option C, B, TESS. It will be named Transiting Exoplanet Survey Satellite, TESS, proved and scheduled to be launched on 16 April 2018. TESS will undertake a 2-year survey mission to uncover previously unknown worlds beyond our solar system. Next question is, 9th Indo-Japan Strategic Dialogue was held in which city? Option A, Tokyo, B, Mumbai, C, Kyoto, or D, Delhi. Let us see the answer. Answer is Tokyo. Option A is correct. The dialogue was co-chaired by External Affairs Minister of India, Sushma Swaraj, and Japanese Foreign Minister, Taro Kono. Both countries agreed to step up cooperation in their special strategic and global partnership and exchanged in loan agreements for $1.4 billion. Next question is, who has been elected as the new president of Egypt? Who has been elected as the new president of Egypt? Option A, Mohamed Morsi, B, Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, C, Hosni Mubarak, or D, Ahmed Shafiq. Let us see the answer. Answer is Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. Option B is correct. Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has been re-elected for second term with a sweeping majority, garnering nearly 92% of the total votes. Next question is, RBI has recently imposed fine on ICICI banks for which one of the following reasons? Option A, not following the guidelines on non-performing assets. Option B, for violating securities sale norms. Option C, aggressive acquisition of other financial services. Option D, none of them. Let us see the answer. Answer is for violating. For violating securities sale norms. The penalty was for violating central bank's directions pertaining to direct sale of securities. The penalty was imposed in exercise of powers vested in RBI under the Banking Regulation Act 1949. ICICI Bank stands for Industrial Credit and Investment Corporation of India with its registered office in Vadodara. Next question is, who has been appointed as the new CEO of Ayushman Bharat Mission? Option A, Indu Bhushan, B, Sanjay K. Jha, C, J.V. Prasad, or D, Rahul Yadav. Let us see the answer. Answer is Indu Bhushan. Option A is correct. Indu Bhushan has been appointed to post for a period of 2 years. Currently, he is the DG of East Asia Department, Asian Development Bank. Next question is, who has been recently appointed as the principal scientific advisor to the Prime Minister? Question is like this. Who has been recently appointed as the principal scientific advisor to the Prime Minister? Option A, Manjul Bhargav, B, Anil Kakodkar, C, K. Vijay Raghavan, or D, Dr. R. Chidambaram. Let us see the answer. Answer is K. Vijay Raghavan. K. Vijay Raghavan is one of the most distinguished biologists of the country. He will succeed 18-year-old
nuclear physicist R. Chidambaram, who was appointed to the post in 2001. Next question is, what percentage of government stake in Air India will be divested? Option A 26%, B 60%, C 76%, or D 100%. Let us see the answer. Answer is 76%. The center will retain 24% stake in Air India and its subsidiary Air India Express. It also proposes divesting 50% of its stake in Air India State SATS Airport Services. Next question is, India's first insect museum was recently unveiled in which Indian state? Question is, India's first insect museum was recently unveiled in which Indian state? Option A Andhra Pradesh, B Uttar Pradesh, C Karnataka, or D Tamil Nadu. Let us see the answer. Answer is Tamil Nadu. Option D is correct. The museum, set up with an outlay of 5 crore rupees, was unveiled by Tamil Nadu Chief Minister K. Palaniswamy at the Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. Next question is, what is the disinvestment target set by the government for the year 2017-18? What is the disinvestment target set by the government for the year 2017-18? Option A 1 trillion, B 5 trillion, C 12 billion, or D 100 million. Let us see the answer. Answer is option A 1 trillion. The Department of Investment and Public Asset Management DIPAM has raised 100056 crore rupees through disinvestment of public sector undertakings in the current fiscal 2017-18.